Have you tried talking to him at his place?
Ich würde gerne erneut mit Will Rice sprechen.
All right. I'll set it up.
Wir haben eine Faser von diesem Sweater am Tatort gefunden.
Oh my god. So you really think I killed Jesse while wearing this sweater? And now I'm wearing it while I'm sitting right here in front of you? This is crazy. I don't know what to say. I swear, anybody could have taken this sweater. Look, maybe someone's trying to frame me.
Wo war dieser Sweater, bevor Sie ihn angezogen haben?
It was in the living room, and I put it on after my shower. I'm pretty sure about that. But I think Jesse may have been wearing it earlier when she left the house. And then I think she came back at some point to drop off some dry cleaning. So I guess she might have left it there then.
Warum bewahren Sie in Ihrem Zimmer flüssiges Morphium auf, Will?
I've never seen that before. It's not mine, and I really don't think it's Jesse's.
Ah, da sollten wir vielleicht nochmal den Fingerabdruck anschauen. Wie kam ein Haar von Veronica in das Bett von Ihnen und Jesse?
It's not like there's some force field keeping Veronica out of our bedroom. We're roommates and we're friends. She comes in there all the time. She plops down on the bed. We talk. That's it. I don't even fantasize that there could be anything more than that.
Erzählen Sie uns von Manny Molines.
Manny? Known him forever. We're real, real close.
Wir haben Manny heute Abend in Ihrem Apartment gefunden.
Yeah, the plumbing's all busted up at his place. So I lent him a key to our place, let him use the shower.
Hat Manny Jessys GPS-Gerät installiert?
Yeah, I bought it for her, but Manny installed it.
Was wissen Sie über den Streit Twitchern? Was wissen Sie über den Streit Twitter? Nee, das macht keinen Sinn als schlechter Witz. Ja, super. Was wissen Sie über den Streit zwischen Jesse und Veronica an dem Abend, an dem sie starb? Bom, bom, bom.
I was taking a nap or trying to. I think I might have heard something. Veronica yelling, but I really can't remember.
Was wissen Sie über diesen Zeitungsausschnitt?
We found this in your apartment. It was hidden inside a book.
I have no idea what that is.
Yes, you have.
You get paid to waste my time like this?
I think you meant to grab a different evidence bag.
Ja, das wollte ich tatsächlich. Da habe ich mich tatsächlich verklickt gerade. Shit. Das hat die Statistik wieder runtergerissen.
I may have touched it, but I still don't really know what it is. I mean, I found it a few weeks ago, just like you did, in one of Jesse's books. I asked her why she was saving it. She said she'd cut it out for one of her friends who was doing some school project on organized crime. Made sense to me, so I left it at that. No big deal.
Okay. Dann werden wir uns nochmal... Ups, nee, halt. Schauplatz wechseln. Dann werden wir uns nochmal die Fingerabdrücke kurz anschauen. Vielleicht kennen wir die ja doch. Zack. Und Fingerabdrücke. Abdrücke. Analyse. Und da haben wir schon einen Treffer. Versenkt. Na? Haha, Meister.
So, Will Rice has his hands on both morphine and cocaine. But is he a murderer?
Das ist die große 1-Million-Dollar-Frage. Bei Who Wants to be a Million? Ach nee, Moment, das war was anderes. So, und nochmal, warum bewahren Sie in Ihrem Zimmer flüssiges Morphium auf, Will?
I've never seen that before. It's not mine.
Doch.
Well, maybe we should give you a blood test, just to be sure.
No, you don't need to do that. The bottle's mine, but it's not what you think. I was in a car accident back in high school, and I've never really bounced back from it. And sometimes, I need that stuff just to take an edge off the pain.
Okay, then why did you lie about it, Will?
Because I didn't kill Jesse, but here she is ODing on a speedball while I'm holding onto a bottle of morphine. I know what it looks like, but you gotta believe me. I would never hurt her.
I choose to believe the evidence, Will.
So you're sitting in the back seat, weren't you, Will? Maybe you came along for the road trip. Maybe not. Regardless, you figured you had the element of surprise on your side. But she surprised you, didn't she? She wasn't gonna go down without a fight. She fought as hard as she could, but in the end, you just overpowered her. You stuck that needle in the back of her neck and plunged that poison into her. And then you injected her one more time in her right arm. Oops, what's the matter with you, Will? You forgot she was right-handed? That was the dead giveaway for us that the scene was staged.
I don't know what the hell you're talking about. I didn't do any of that.
Na, hier sind wir fertig und tatsächlich haben wir Beweise, die ihm recht geben. Diesmal ist es offensichtlich. Ich meine, in anderen Fällen war es nicht so offensichtlich wie hier. Ich muss Veronica Carver vorladen, um sie zu befragen.
Based on what evidence?
Naja, wie wär's mit dem Telefonat?
So she never said anything about getting into a fight with Jessica? It's suspicious. But do you have anything that actually ties Veronica to the crime scene?
Yep.
So you're telling me you matched this DNA sample to another one you recovered from a styrofoam coffee cup? A coffee cup Veronica Carver allegedly threw away at the car wash, but you didn't actually see her toss it? I'm sorry, I'm gonna need more.
Gut, dann noch der Sweater.
So Will Rice alleges this is a communal apartment sweater, huh? Meaning he and Veronica both had easy access to it, and it matches the fiber found in the car wash brushes. Okay, let's bring her in.
Tja, drei Beweise. Alle guten Dinge sind drei. Und du gleich im Knast.
Miss Carver, your roommate died from a lethal injection of cocaine and morphine. But she didn't inject herself. Someone stabbed her in the back of the neck with a needle. And then that person tried unsuccessfully to make it look like an accidental overdose.
You mean Jesse was murdered?
Yes. And we have some additional questions for you.
Sure. I mean, whatever I can do to help.
Help? Mhm. Was können Sie uns über den roten Gemeinschaftssweater sagen?
Mr. Rice claims it's left out in your living room. That anyone and everyone can wear it. Well, we found a fiber from it at the crime scene.
Weird. I wouldn't know how it got there.
Was wissen Sie über diesen Zeitungsausschnitt? Das will ich mal zur Sicherheit vorher fragen.
Does this picture mean anything to you?
No, never seen it before.
We believe it was familiar to both Will and Jesse.
Could have been. I don't know. Neither one of them ever showed it to me.
Okay, sind Sie und Jesse gut miteinander klargekommen?
You seemed pretty shaken by her death.
I kinda knew about Jesse's struggle with drugs, so it was bad enough to think she'd OD'd. But now you're saying someone killed her. It's just hard to wrap my mind around the whole thing. But yeah, we were really close. And I'm gonna miss her a lot.
Ja, nicht so ganz. Da sagt das Handy und die Voicemail ein bisschen was anderes.
Look, it's not like we didn't have our differences. And we lived under the same roof, so yeah, we argued every once in a while. But now, all that stuff we ever fought about seems incredibly stupid.
Ms. Carver, on your voice message to Jessica, you told her, and I quote, "You can't just walk away from this." Walk away from what, exactly?
In all honesty, I really didn't feel she was treating Will right. I knew she was keeping things from him. I mean, he knew about the drugs and the road trips, but there were other things. Calls she'd step outside to take, and she was always texting somebody. And then there were times when she'd leave the house, and I'd ask her where she was going, but she'd refuse to tell me. She just had too many secrets.
Okay, können Sie erklären, warum wir eines Ihrer Haare im Bett von Jesse und Will fanden?
I know what you're thinking, and for the record, I got over Will a long time ago. But now, we're roommates and we're really good friends, so yes, I have been known on occasion to visit with him in the bedroom he shares with Jesse. I've sat on the bed, I've probably even taken a nap on that bed, but that is the extent of my activity in that room.
Sie erwähnten, dass Jesse mit Manny herumgemacht habe?
I saw Manny pick up Jesse from the house a few nights ago. Obviously, Will wasn't home. And I was supposed to work a double that night, but I got cut. Jesse didn't think anybody was gonna see her take off with him, but I did.
Wurde es gewalttätig?
You certainly sounded angry in your message. You said you'd kill Jesse if she hurt Will.
Look, I'm not gonna lie to you. I was very serious about confronting Jesse about the lies she was telling to Will. But that didn't mean I was really gonna kill her. I mean, it didn't even mean I was gonna throw down with her or anything. I'm not into violence.
Wussten Sie, dass Will Morphium genommen hat?
Yes, I knew. He got into an accident back in high school. His leg's never really been the same since.
Mr. Rice refused to disclose how he acquired the morphine. Do you know anything about that, Ms. Carver? That same bottle of morphine contributed to Jessica's death.
Will didn't do it.
Are you sure about that, Ms. Carver?
I'll never understand why, but Will was crazy in love with Jesse. There is no possible way he killed her.
Then where did he get the morphine?
I don't know.
I think you do, Ms. Carver. And if you really want to protect Will, you'll need to start telling us the whole truth. Right now.
Will's not telling you where it came from, because it came from me. I got it for him. I got it from the hospital.
Why would you do that for him? Why jeopardize your entire career?
Because the accident... It was my fault, okay? That's why. We were just stupid kids and we'd both had too much to drink, but I was the one driving. I knew it was risky sneaking the morphine out, but there were just so many times Will was in such pain and he asked me, and I couldn't refuse.
Wurde es gewalttätig?
I'm not into violence.
Das habe ich mir extra zum Schluss aufgespart, denn wir haben die DNA unter den Fingernägeln.
Okay. So, if you were planning on having this civilized discussion with Jessie about her dishonesty, could you tell us how your DNA ended up under her fingernails?
It started out civilized, then the volume got turned up, and it got a little physical. Jessie pulled my hair, and she slapped me. She denied everything.
Das war schon wieder ein zu harter Cut im Video. Das ist alles im Moment.
Don't leave town.
I'm not going anywhere.
It's Nick. I'll put him on speaker.
Hey there. So I recovered that data from Jessica Marnier's GPS. I'm uploading it to your case file right now. So here's how it breaks down. She starts out at her apartment, then she heads over to an address belonging to a fellow named Manuel Molinez. Then she goes to a dry cleaner's and then back to her apartment. And finally she ends up at the car wash. Hope that helps you guys. Talk to you later.
Thanks, Nikki. Another sin of omission. Manny didn't tell us he'd seen Jessie. Let's pay him a visit and see what else he's hiding.
Okay, ich war jetzt ziemlich sicher, dass Veronica die Täterin war. Oder sei.
I just got off the phone with Brass. You want to hear something interesting? Brass was going over Manuel Molinez's records, and guess who Manny allegedly ran a shipment of drugs for last year? Beatrice Salazar. Of course, that connection was never fully substantiated. But isn't it curious how we can't seem to get out of her business?
Es ist, also die Wendung, dass es doch wieder in Richtung Manny ging. Gut, man könnte jetzt so im Nachhinein sagen, war fast schon vorher...
I guess that must be from the plumbing problems Manny mentioned.
Fast schon vorherzusehen vielleicht. Und... Ich hätte es vielleicht erwarten müssen oder können, habe ich aber halt am Ende nicht.
That'll probably be from Manny's latest round of community service.
Gut, gibt's da aber irgendwas? Oh!
Anything outside of the trailer like this is in plain sight. We don't need a warrant for it.
Vielen Dank.
Okay, Manny's got a picture on his phone of Will and Veronica together. Apparently rekindling the old flame. Phone looks pretty clean otherwise. Hang on, there's a message in the sent box from Manny to Jessie. I'll download it into your case file. It says, she's dangerous, don't risk it. I'm gonna guess she is Veronica.
Okay, she's dangerous, don't risk it. Was sollte sie nicht riskieren? Und inwiefern ist Veronica gefährlich? Jemand da?
Come in, officers. Mika says, never mind. Su casa probably ain't a dump like this, huh?
Ist das nicht eigentlich Russisch? Nee, Moment. Woher kommt das nochmal?
What you need, officers? You didn't come out here because I'm popular.
Wir wissen, dass Jessie sie am Abend ihres Todes besucht hat.
Well, not only did you fail to mention that, you also made it sound like you barely knew Jessica.
Yeah, well, she blew by, you know, real quick-like. Just wanted to ask me something about Will, get a guy's perspective on the situation, that sort of thing. I was surprised to see her tell you the truth.
Haben Sie jemals Speedballs verkauft, Manny?
If you can smoke it or snort it or stick it, I've sold it. But that's like past, you know, tense. I'm on parole, but you guys already know that. So, if you're really asking me if I sold to Jessie and or Will, My answer's no.